Kutchin Refinery School, the epitome of wisdom. Situated in the picturesque hilltop in Ambalamukku. This voyage of education started 50 years ago. On the 11th of August, 1966, Mr. Taylor Martin opened the school in two houses at Jualagiri, from Standard 1 to Standard 6, with 7 teachers and 110 students.
One of the greatest things that I had in my life was to become a part of Kutchin Refinery. Not only the professional aspect of my job, but also from my family point of view, refinery provided a school where my children went and studied. I am very grateful to refinery for the provision of the school. And also it was headed by capable professors and teachers whose main function they discharge very well, teach the children. And also by discipline and order, we insisted the children must study and obey the teachers.
From the very beginning, the Kochi refinery management felt that the educational system that was prevailing in the schools in the region was insufficient and incomplete for the overall development of the children. Keeping this defect in mind, CRL management designed a system for CRL school for the overall development of the children. We used to say that the employees refine the petroleum crude in the refinery into various petroleum products, while the teachers refine the employees' children into good human beings.
A humble beginning under the able administration of Mr. K.C. Jacob, the first principal. Mr. Jacob, who had completed his master's in nuclear physics from the Brown University, USA, was a man of principles and gave utmost importance to the development of his students and the school. The school building took to life with Mr. Roy Umbe laying the foundation stone in 1967. On 26 July 1968, the school building was inaugurated by Dr. A.T. Marcos, Dean of the Faculty of Law, Kerala University, at a function presided over by Dr. M.V. Pillai, Director of the School of Business Management, University of Kochin, Kerala. Then, there was no looking back. Kochin Refinery School grew, with the first batch of Standard 11 passing out in 1972. A few names to mention are Meena George, Ramu Krishnamurthy, Paul Augustine, Wilfred Pinto, Heidi Ellen D'Souza. The school is run by Kochin Refinery's Educational Aid Society, managed by Board of Governors nominated by the management of BPCL Kochi Refinery.
Kochin Refinery School has an amazing journey in the last 50 years. The school started operation even before the refinery commenced its activities. The school has produced very outstanding citizens to the country, and many of the students who came out of the school are doing very successful in their life. The refinery was also able to achieve its better performance because of a committed and motivated workforce. That was also indirectly contributed by the school, because most of the employees had their children in the school and indirectly helped them to attain a better results because of their emotional attachment with the school as well as to the company. At this time of Golden Jubilee, I wish all the success for the school in their future endeavors. The quality of the educational process in the school was excellent. The staff as well as the other employees of school ensured that topmost quality is maintained in all the activities of the school. At this time, since the company is growing, as the part of this process, the school is being relocated to a better place, and hopefully by 2018 middle, the school would start functioning from the new location. Once again, wish all the success for the school.
Cochin Refinery School has grown leaps and bounds for the past 50 years. It gives me an immense pleasure that I am holding the school chairmanship during its Golden Jubilee year. It is only appropriate to remember the visionary leadership of Mr. Tyler Martin, the refinery manager who started the school at Jualagiri, and Mr. Roy D. Mumbach of Phillips Petroleum Corporation, who laid the foundation stone. At this juncture, we should also remember Mr. K.C. Jacob, who was the first principal, and the other dedicated teachers with due respect and honor. But for their hard work and dedication, the CR school would not have been like this as it stands today.
Here, Mother Nature, students, teachers, and non-teaching staff join together in harmony to create a world of colors and knowledge, ready to contribute responsible citizens for the country. The bell is gone, and another fresh day commences. Today, Cochin Refinery School has completed 50 years of existence. This academic year, she has over 1,000 students and 50 teaching and non-teaching staff under the supervision of Mrs. Malabi Menon, school principal.
I feel extremely proud and privileged to be heading Cochin Refinery School as its sixth principal. The school has a rich legacy. We are trying to bring out refined and radiated students from the portals of this school.
We are offering here a holistic style of education to all the students. That is, the overall development of the student is our objective. Not mere the academics, we have all the co-curricular, extracurricular, scholastic and co-scholastic activities.
The journey, 50 years ago.
I would go back to 1965 when we first returned from Bombay, where my father, Mr. O.S. Yusuf, was working in Caltex. He and his wife, Mrs. Jamila Yusuf, all of us came down in 1965. And for a year, I studied in a school in Cochin. 65 to 1966 was the time of the inception and execution of the plan of Cochin Refinery School. We remember days when there were lots of discussion happening at home, and especially the teething problems. 1965 to 66, in that 1 year, they had to get permission from not only from the Kerala state government but also from the central government. And the late Mr. C.H. Mohammed Koya, who was the education minister of Kerala then, was very helpful in getting the local procedures completed. Interestingly, Mr. K.G. Main, who was a liaison officer for Cochin Refineries in Delhi, was very influential and could get the permission within 1 year to officially start the school in 1966. And what not, a lovely cosmopolitan society we had. Children not only knew each other, but their parents too.
Jualagiri. The land where a housing colony was situated was an evergreen home to many students. The land which was home to many. The land which was the playground for many. The land where our beloved school is situated. Cochin Refinery School was the platform to over 3,000 students who have been groomed by dedicated teachers into responsible individuals and spreading their values into the society.
Knowledge makes you great.
The CR school teachers. They taught little hearts to visualize their dreams and guided them all. Till they left the steps of the school to realize their dreams. CRS is proud to have had able and dedicated teachers in her roles. Dr. K.N. Nambishan, one of her senior most teachers who was instrumental in bringing the Scouts and Guides movement. Mrs. Portia Iso, who won the President's Award for the Best Teacher way back in 1985. Our principals, Mr. K.C. Jacob, Mr. Lalit Potan, Mrs. Agatha Thomas, Mrs. Janet Lobo, and Dr. Kim Sujata.
I came to Cochin Refineries simply because I thought that I would be near our home, Kerala. Mr. Jacob was the principal, and we had a team of dedicated teachers. And thus, all the teachers put in hard work. We wanted to bring up the school, because the school was in its infancy. And Mr. Jacob was able to guide everybody, and I had my own contributions. Because our main job was to set the proper track and to build up our own way. Certainly, Cochin Refinery School should be something different from other schools, we thought.
When I joined the school as a physical education teacher, there was no play field. Actually, the ground was developed by the Cochin Refineries management as well as the school authorities. I was a part of the team that constructed the Ambalamugal Oval.
I joined the school in 1971. Those times the classes were very small in strength. We used to have a one-to-one relation there in the class between the teacher and the students. All parents we knew very well, and it was a very close-knit family of CR employees and the school staff.
The concept of holistic education was unfolding in front of me. Though I was started my career as a physics teacher, actually the school experience gave me to become turned into an educationist in the later years. But when I see this educational career as a whole, definitely my foundation was laid in Cochin Refinery School, where I worked under two principals, Mr. Jacob and Mr. Potan.
It has been a glorious experience for me, because in this school we had the best management, who gave us freely whatever we required. We
went in not only for academics but also co-curricular activities in like shuttle, tennis, we have basketball, volleyball, all the games, and along with that we also have a very good band and very good activities.
എന്നിലെ അധ്യാപികയ്ക്ക് പൂർണ്ണത കൈവരിക്കാൻ സഹായിച്ച മഹനീയ വിദ്യാനികേതനമാണ് അമ്പലമുകളിൽ പരിലസിക്കുന്ന കൊച്ചിൻ റിഫൈനറീസ് സ്കൂൾ. ഓരോ വിദ്യാർത്ഥിയുടെയും ബൗദ്ധികവും കായികവും കലാപരവുമായ കഴിവുകളെ വികസിപ്പിച്ചെടുക്കാൻ ഞങ്ങളെല്ലാവരും ബദ്ധശ്രദ്ധരായിരുന്നു. അതിന് വേണ്ടതായ എല്ലാ സൗകര്യങ്ങളും സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യവും പ്രോത്സാഹനങ്ങളും അന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് കൊച്ചിൻ റിഫൈനറിയിൽ നിന്ന് ലഭിച്ചിരുന്നു എന്ന് പറയുമ്പോൾ എനിക്ക് വളരെയധികം ചാരിതാർത്ഥ്യവും സംതൃപ്തിയും സന്തോഷവും ഉണ്ട്.
കൊച്ചിൻ റിഫൈനറി സ്കൂൾ സ്റ്റാൻഡ്സ് ടോൾ ഇൻ ദ പ്രൊമോഷൻ ഓഫ് ഗെയിംസ് ആൻഡ് സ്പോർട്സ് റീച്ചിംഗ് ദ ഡിസ്ട്രിക്ട് ആൻഡ് നാഷണൽ ലെവൽ. The summer coaching classes groom the young athletes in various games and sports.
I joined the school, the refinery school, in the first year itself, 1966, and I worked for 15 years. I could take good interest and I could give proper guidance to the children.
CRS has introduced the National Cadet Corps Movement and continue the Scouts and Guides program, which provides opportunity to students to become responsible and disciplined citizens of the nation.
ആദ്യമായി സ്കൂളിൽ വന്നപ്പോൾ എന്നെ വളരെ അത്ഭുതപ്പെടുത്തിയത് ഈ സ്കൂളിലെ ഡിസിപ്ലിനെ കുറിച്ച് ഡിസിപ്ലിനാണ് എന്നെ ഏറ്റവും കൂടുതൽ അത്ഭുതപ്പെടുത്തിയത്.
CRS proudly presents the golden melody of the school band. Trumpets and bugles blowing notes of praises. Young champions of ethics, children of Love Green Club grew together with nature, planting up saplings and nurturing them, conserving the environment through awareness programs, seminars, plus 10 projects. CRS promotes creativity in all walks of life. Students are encouraged to improve their skills in painting and art, as well as in vocational skills.
Along with the school, from 400 to 1,300 and odd children now. So I am very happy that I could grow along with the school.
I joined the school as a faculty member of the Department of Commerce during the year 1989 as an economics teacher. I remember that during that year, in the office we were having 38 staff and 9 non-teaching staff members. And among them, I remember the name of Mr. Ambrose, who was an attendant at that time. Now he is the deputy collector. It only tells us how a patience, hard work will make you to the greater heights.
When I joined, it was only one or two divisions for each class, and now I feel there are almost 3 divisions and more than 1,300 students in the school. And almost all the students of the school are well placed and they are doing well.
For 3 decades,
Cochin Refinery School gave me immense opportunities to open up young minds, to stretch and strengthen the mental muscles of my students, which could have enabled them to be strong in their lives, find their own way, take challenging decisions, and become independent.
CRS is growing with technology. The introduction of smart classes has provided students with the art of visual learning. Practical sessions are conducted in science laboratories.
Now I'm 80 years old. I don't feel lonely. I don't feel bored up because I got plenty of books to read. I always believe there is a silent contract you sign when you learn the alphabet that you will be reading till the end of your life. So read. Read everything, anything. Let it be sheer nonsense, because a lot of nonsense makes some sense. That's my attitude.
Volunteering has always been a part of life in CRS. Students themselves serve lunch, help clean the surroundings and others. The club and the park, which grew up along with the school, who have seen many falls and smiles, laughter and cries of joy. The mango tree holds memories of many a child. Honoring old students, a new initiative to honor all those former students who have reached excellence in various walks of life. The Old Students Association, Smriti, which catches up regularly, shows a never-dying love for their alma mater.
It's 40 years and beyond. A rollback, indeed a very long time. But there isn't anything like getting back to my old schooling days. The school which helped me to organize those alphabets of life. I'm deeply indebted to all my gurus who toiled very hard to make me what I am today. The contributions of all my gurus invaluable. All I can now do is bow my head in gratitude to all of them.
I started my schooling from Cochin Refinery School. I think I'm very, very fortunate, and I'm also really proud to say that I studied in this school and now I'm working in Cochin Refinery School. What I am today is all because of the blessings of my gurus. Pranams to all my gurus.
On the occasion of the Golden Jubilee of my school, Cochin Refinery School, I recall that what I am today, 50 years, is the foundation that was laid of my character, of my academics, of my overall development of personality in school. Many foundations were laid, not only of the building, but also of all the characters of all what we are today. We have to be grateful and thank the school, teachers, and of course not forgetting our parents. Importantly, work hard, sincerely, and honestly. Everything else, name, fame, will follow you like a shadow.
Cochin Refinery School began a Jubilee celebrations with a host of programs. 50 talks by eminent personalities, a golden Christmas, and a patriotic Republic Day function.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
CRS is always in the forefront of building relationships. inter-school competition was conducted on 2nd July with enthusiastic participation from neighboring schools. Honor those teachers who taught the students to dream their future. Former teachers, former students joined with the present teachers and staff and students to revive their long-lasting relationships that never die. CRS is all set to move into greener pastures of learning, involving little hearts.
Soon we should be moving to a more spacious, modern school with the state-of-art facilities at Vandipeta.
Every June, Cochin Refinery School eagerly awaits the footsteps and chatter of students after the quietness of summer holidays. She goes alive again to pave the way to realize a thousand dreams, to lay the foundation of their ambitions, to give flight to their little wings, taking them to greater heights of excellence. Kochi Refinery School completing 50 years of existence as an exemplary school of dynamic learning.